Hi, today I'm going to present the library C-Frame, how this project was born, and what are its use cases. But first, let's talk about what C-Frame is. It's a fork of the Reframe library, where the reactivity is handled by Signally instead of the reagent atoms. How this project started? Signally was extracted from Vrac to be in his own library, so that it can be used by other projects. During the development, we needed to know if it was good enough for large projects, and if nothing was missing in its API for covering all the use cases. So we needed to use it, and then we would know. Reagent is the closest to Signally in terms of functionalities, as they both provide reactive primitives. If Signally's API is good enough, we should already be able to use it to implement something like reagent using it. And that's exactly what we did. We wrote a project called C-Agent, which implements a part of the reagent API. C-Agent allows programmers to use function components with Reframe 19 from ClojureScript by using the same patterns as reagent. It lacks all the backward compatibility and some of the features that you can find in reagent, but it works pretty well otherwise. But the test was not over. The project was not large enough. There were some other libraries which use reactive primitives in the Azure ecosystem. Reframe is one of them. But technically, how to combine it with C-Agent for our experiment? C-Agent is using Signally for its reactivity, and Reframe is using the reagent atoms. Both systems don't match, and we have to overcome this mismatch. The solution we found was to ensure that the C-Agent library is compatible with the reagent atoms API, well enough so that Reframe can use it without changing its main implementation. Let's take a look at how we forked Reframe and the changes we did on it. The last table version is 1.4.3. We needed another number for the fork versioning, so we added 0.0 at the end. Next, we swapped the reagent dependency with C-Agent. We found that Reframe was implemented in a way that makes it easy to change the reactivity primitives on which it is based. The interrupt namespace is the only interface between Reframe's main logic and reagent. Since C-Agent keeps the same namespaces as reagent and the same RATOM API, we only needed to swap some low-level details like the type of the reagent atom, which is now iReactiveNode, from Signally. At this point, C-Frame was already working together with C-Agent and the demo projects from Reframes were running on it. We also added a special function to interface C-Frame's subscriptions with React Hooks, so that it can be used in UIX. At this point, we realized that the dependency on C-Agent was not really needed anywhere in C-Frame. So we crafted another release where C-Frame is using Signally directly. The version number has a prefix -no-C-Agent. We swapped the C-Agent dependency with Signally. In the interop namespace, we remove the references to the reagent namespace. We replace the use of the reagent atoms with direct use of Signally's reactive nodes. And that's it. C-Frame became free of any dependency related to reagent or React, and has gained, in exchange, a clean, glitch-free, lazy reactivity provided by Signally. So what can C-Frame be used for? What are the use cases? UIX apps can use it to manage their states without reagent. It can be useful if the app has no legacy code, which are using the reagent components. But it can also be used by any other library that updates a DOM, and not only React, provided that it knows how to update the DOM when a Signally node is updated. I happen to have such a library, it's Vrac, which can now use reframe via the cframe fork. Vrac is already updating the DOM based on Signally's reactive nodes, and because cframe subscriptions are actually Signally's reactive nodes, there is absolutely nothing to change in Vrac to make them work together. So it's a kind of funny development, where Signally was extracted from Vrac to be used for other purposes, but in the end, Signally is bridging external libraries back to Vrac. We ported a simple clock demo from reframe to Vrac, and here is a small demo. In this page, you can see two components, one which is showing what time it is, and one which contains the input. The input is controlled input, so you can modify it, and each time you modify it, it updates the state in a cframe. I like the color light green, so let's keep it. Let's take a look at the source code. This part, which is triggering some or dispatching some events, is left unchanged. This part, which is handling events, is also left unchanged. And this part, which is the subscriptions, is also left unchanged. The only part which is changing is related to the view library. Cframe is still using the same namespace as reframe. So there, again, nothing to change. Let's take a look at the views. Here we don't have a reagent component or a UIX component. We have a Vrac component, which is using directly the subscription for reframe. In this case, we are deriving a value from a reactive value time, and this derived value is actually the formatting of the time into a string. And using Vrac, we update the text in this element. And we also use Vrac to update the color of this element based on another subscription which gives the color. Because we are not using React, we don't have the same issue that some old React application has. For example, we don't have the jumping caret problem. This is a small bonus, but this is what you get. So Vrac is not production ready yet, but if you want to give it a try, the data management at least will be very familiar to you. That's all for this video. I hope that you liked the presentation. Have a good day and see you next time.